This tree has a cavity, a death top, and a crack in the trunk. It looks dangerous, but only one of these things can actually mean real trouble. And that's exactly what we're going to talk about today. Tree cavities are an instant scare for a lot of people. You see a hole in the trunk and the first thought is, there's no way this can still be safe. But the reality is different. A cavity is often not a problem for a tree at all. It's very often a natural part of the aging process. One thing needs to be said clearly right at the start. A cavity means a loss of some wood, but it does not automatically mean a loss of stability. The tree doesn't stop working, it just works a bit differently. With cavities, what matters is not that wood decomposition is happening, but how much wood is lost, where exactly that loss is, and how the tree has responded to it. Three things are decisive: the size of the cavity in relation to the size of the tree, its height and trunk diameter, the position of the cavity in the trunk, is it central or does it affect the outer shell, and most importantly, the tree's response. A tree is not a column. A tree is a living organism. What's more, these trees are often among the most biologically valuable ones. Cavities provide shelter for birds, bats, insects, fungi. Now let's look at the difference. Here we have a tree with a cavity that may look alarming, but structurally it is stable. It has a low center of gravity, a large trunk diameter, and above all, it has been responding over the long term. And then there's another example, a tree that looks much better at first glance, but it is slender, with a high center of gravity, and the cavity shows no visible compensation. And that is exactly the difference that often gets overlooked without proper knowledge. Today, we have a range of diagnostic methods that allow us to analyze cavities precisely from a tree stability perspective. Most of them are based on 3D scans of the trunk, and they don't have to be expensive at all, especially when compared to the high value of hollow trees, which are genuinely rare in nature. Another thing that often scares people about trees is a dying top. Dry branches in the upper crown, a drying out tip, and the verdict comes immediately. The tree is dying. But here it's crucial to remember one key sentence. A dead top is not a diagnosis. It's a symptom. And like any symptom, it can mean completely different things depending on what kind of tree we're looking at. In young trees and in short-lived species, dieback of the top is usually bad news. It often means that something has failed. Poor planting, insufficient root space, long-term stress, drought, or root damage. In these cases, the tree is essentially telling us, I can't cope. And here, a dead top is a warning signal that should not be ignored. But now comes a crucial turning point. In old and long-lived trees, the very same phenomenon can mean something entirely different. Here, top dieback doesn't have to be a collapse, but a controlled reduction of the crown. The tree is reducing crown volume, lowering the demands on water and nutrient transport, and redirecting energy to parts that are sustainable in the long term. This process is called retrenchment. Through this process, a tree can stabilize itself and continue to function for a very long time. The problem is that from the outside, it looks bad. And this is exactly where one of the biggest mistakes in tree assessment comes from. The same symptom, a completely different meaning. Now we get to things that really shouldn't be brushed aside. Not everything that looks bad on a tree is a problem, but here it's time to pay attention. Cracks in the trunk are exactly the kind of damage where the details matter. Not every crack automatically means danger. Old healed cracks, usually running vertically and no longer opening, can be stable and functional over the long term. But then there are other cases, fresh cracks. Cracks that cut across the grain into a horizontal direction. Active cracks that continue to open. And here, a red flag goes up. A crack is not just a surface defect. It is a disruption of the continuity of the tree's load-bearing structure. In other words, forces that were previously distributed evenly are suddenly concentrated into a much smaller area, and the tree may not have time to respond. Reaction wood is only just forming, if at all. That's why, when it comes to cracks, a simple rule applies. Don't panic, but don't underestimate them. This is the moment when it makes sense to bring in a professional and look at the tree in context. Not out of fear, but to make a decision that's grounded in reality, not just in first impressions. And now we come to the signal that I consider the most serious of all the ones mentioned. Leaning trunk. A leaning tree on its own doesn't have to be a problem. Trees lean quite commonly, usually towards the light or in the direction of prevailing winds. The crucial question is this: did the tree have time to adapt? There's a simple rule. A leaning tree is not a problem. A tree that cannot cope with its lean is. A healthy tree responds to lean. It forms reaction wood. It changes the architecture of the trunk and the crown. It reinforces where needed and adjusts the distribution of mass. These changes are readable during assessment if we know where to look. But if a tree is leaning and we see no such compensation, the situation becomes serious. It can indicate a failure of the root system, insufficient anchorage, damage that the tree cannot compensate for. The combination of lean and a lack of response from the tree is one of the clearest warning signals there is. This is often an emergency situation. If you really want to understand trees and not make decisions based on first impressions, subscribe to this channel. The next videos go deeper and show real life cases from practice. And if this video made sense to you, a like helps it reach more people.